Hey guys, missed me? I'm back with yet another video which I know you all have been eagerly waiting for. It is one of the most important videos of Blup's beginner series, and it is going to be about Blup Editor. So without wasting any time, let's get started. Alright, so when you open the Blup application, you'll be able to see a dashboard displaying your projects. To create a new project, begin by providing an app name for your project. Leave the remaining details as default and click on the Next button. Next, select any plan you wish to choose. We are selecting the Start for Free one and proceed. Now, to help you understand the workings of Blup Editor in depth, let's divide Blup Editor into three parts. First one is the top bar. Second one is the left panel. And the third one is the right panel. And at the center, you can see the area with a mobile screen, which is called Canvas. Let's break it down step by step, starting with the left bar in Blup Editor, known as the Layers/Pages panel. This panel displays all the elements you create on the canvas. To simplify this concept, think of an onion with its multiple layers. Similarly, your app consists of overlapping elements, and each element forms a separate layer that can be viewed on the left side in the Layers panel. At the top of the left panel, you will find the Pages and Layers tab. The Pages tab contains all the pages you have created on the canvas. The Layers tab, on the other hand, contains all the individual elements you have created within the selected page. Just above the Pages and Layers tabs, there are additional options such as Search, Bookmark, and the Menu bar. The Search option allows you to search for specific layers. With the Bookmark option, you can mark and access your preferred layers and pages. By utilizing these options, you can efficiently navigate and manage your app's elements within the Blup Editor. After that, on the right-hand side, we have the Properties panel. Here, you can edit the properties of the elements that you draw on the canvas, like its color, width, or height. After that, in the center, we have the canvas. And this white sheet is called the page. When you create something inside the page, it reflects what you want to be shown on your app's page. Note, if you create something outside the page and on the canvas, it will not be shown on the screen when you run your app. After the canvas, let's talk about the top bar. In the top bar, first option you'll get is the new page, which you can use if you want to add a new page. Next is the insert option, through which you can insert widgets/components inside your canvas. After insert comes the import Figma file button. So if you have made designs in Figma, you can easily import them in your project. For that, all you require is file ID and a token, and it will directly get imported into the canvas. Next to the import option, you'll find the analyzer. The analyzer specifically works with logics, and if any of the logic nodes have errors, they will be reflected and shown in this analyzer. Essentially, the analyzer helps identify if everything is functioning correctly or if there are any errors that need attention. After the analyzer, you'll see the devices connected section. This shows a list of connected devices on which you can run your project, such as mobile or web devices. After devices connected comes the run button. With this button, you can now run your app on different devices. After you click on the run button, your app will run on your connected devices in 1 to 2 minutes. After this, you can also open the debug console by clicking on view details buttons. And if you want to stop, click on the square shaped stop button. The picture is not over yet. Then comes the hot reload button. This helps you when you update or make any changes inside your project. And when you click on the hot reload, it will reflect the made changes into your app. And next to it, you're also able to see the hot restart button. And the hot restart button is used when you want to restart your app from scratch. And then comes the publish button, which you can finally use to publish your app. Last but not the least, we have the navigation bar, which contains icons for home, design, logic, and backend. At the corner of the navigation bar, you'll find the help button. If you encounter any problems or difficulties while using Blup, you can click on the help button for assistance. I promise, it's done. We have explored the wonders of Blup Editor and left you with a taste of its amazing features. But don't you worry, we are not done yet. Stay tuned for our upcoming Blup Designer overview video, where we will dive deeper into this fascinating tool. Get ready to unleash your creativity and embark on a wild journey of app creation with Blup. Also, if you like the video, do hit the like, share, and subscribe button. I'll see you soon. Till then, keep blupping.